for patients who present for treatment in colorectal cancer, so their first diagnosis with metastatic colon cancer, there are actually a number of options for those patients, and it all depends on the expansive number of options will depend on whether the patients have a mutation in the RAS pathway or not. So assuming that this patient has no mutation in the RAS pathway, there are at least four different options: FOLFIRI bevacizumab, FOLFOX bevacizumab, FOLFIRI, one of the EGFR inhibitors, either cetuximab or panitumumab, and FOLFOX, again, either cetuximab plus panitumumab. So there are a number of options that would be available to those patients. And this is where you start really thinking about individualizing care, toxicity, efficacy, the patient's preferences. Some of these agents may lead to losing your hair, and some patients prefer not to lose their hair. These are the irinotecan-based regimens. EGFR inhibitors can cause a rash, and some patients prefer not to show, at least in the first line, their cancer. A rash is an indication of treatment, so they'd rather not be on EGFR inhibitors. On the other hand, if a patient is a pianist or uses their hands, they need their fingers for dexterity, they may be averse to neurotoxicity, which is mostly what you see with oxaliplatin. So you have a menu of options, which is good, and they all seem to be reasonably active and equivalent in many ways. For the RAS-mutated patients, so those with mutations in RAS, you're really limited to either FOLFIRI or FOLFOX with bevacizumab. And it's mostly the chemotherapy backbone and its toxicities that may drive that decision.